Could an ancient megalodon defeat a modern orca pod? You might not realize it, but one of the most dangerous animals on the planet, if it's not the most dangerous, is the orca. Now, add to that, they travel in groups. Yes, an orca pod is a deadly group of predators that are strong and highly intelligent. We're not sure that anything living could even stop them, but maybe someone who went extinct a long time ago could have. The ancient megalodon. He was a beast, enormous, a frightening sight. So, could he have defeated a modern orca pod? Orca pod. There are many misconceptions about orcas, but the nickname killer whale is not one of them. You see how intelligent they are, the tricks they can learn, but do not confuse this with being a peaceful animal. They're hunters, but they're the kind of hunters that make other hunters watch on in awe. They don't just kill, they dismantle. Now, the megalodon was no treat, but did he have enough to take down an orca pod? Or will we be surprised by what these whales can do? Most whales, like blue whales, have baleen for teeth, and they are filter feeders. They just swim towards large schools of krill with their mouths open and let the food swim on in. An orca is a toothed whale, teeth made to do some damage. They are the largest of the dolphin family, which explains their immense intelligence. The dolphin family is one of the smartest animal families on the planet, so now imagine the largest member of that family, and imagine he hunts for food. You have a scary combination. You have the orca. A few more scary facts about orcas. They are the second largest predator of the ocean, only behind the sperm whale. And by the way, sometimes they attack and eat sperm whales, so they're very clearly the apex predator of all apex predators of the seas. Combine that size with speed. They're the second fastest marine mammal, able to hit speeds of 35 miles per hour. Have you dipped in the water? Are you nervous and orcas looking you up and down, wondering what you taste like? Don't worry, they probably won't want to eat you. They eat a variety of animals, but humans aren't included. They'll eat many kinds of fish, seals, rays. Yes, they'll eat dolphins and whales, and yes, they'll eat sharks. No animal in the water is safe, except you. That is, as long as you aren't trying to trap the orca, then you're in just as much trouble. Orcas are often called wolves of the sea because they hunt in packs. And this is where their vastly superior communication and intelligence comes into play, because they don't have just one way of hunting. They will hunt in whatever way is necessary for the prey. If they are hunting rays which dwell near the ocean floor, they'll corner them, pin them down, and then bring them up to the surface. If they are hunting sharks, they'll often herd them to the surface and strike them with their tail flukes. Sometimes, when the prey they want is on floating ice, they will make waves to knock them off and into the water before attacking. A pod of these deadly orcas could be as little as 4 members, it could be as many as 16. No matter how many there are, they work together, they communicate flawlessly, and there is really no one stronger or more intelligent than them in the ocean. Modern sharks. You might be thinking, hold on, they're not the superior predator when compared to every predator in the ocean, right? We've always known sharks to be apex predators. Well, sharks are apex predators when orcas aren't around. And like we mentioned, orcas aren't just attacking sharks, they're eating them. In some parts of the world, they make hammerheads and mako sharks part of their normal diet. They eat blue sharks, basking sharks, and common threshers. But you're thinking, okay, those aren't the biggest sharks, though. For instance, there's the whale shark, biggest shark in the world, biggest fish in the world. They can grow up to 40 feet and be 40,000 pounds. An orca is about 25 feet long and weighs around 8,000 pounds. Well, we got news for you. In some parts of the world, orcas eat whale sharks too. But now you're thinking, hold on, whale sharks aren't dangerous predators or anything. What about the king of all sharks? The great white, a 15-foot, 2,500-pound behemoth, a terror ripping through the waters like a knife through hot butter and tearing through its prey. With a shocking bite force of 4,000 psi, third highest on the planet, not the great white. First, that bite force is child's play compared to the orcas, 19,000 psi. He could bite through a great white with one chomp, and he has, on many occasions. Sometimes great whites try to pick off young orcas, and the adult orcas defend and destroy. And sometimes they just hunt great whites, and they do so easily, killing them in a matter of minutes and then feasting on their bodies. So no shark is safe if an orca pool is near. Deadliest animals of the ocean, in modern times at least. Because we haven't yet talked about who used to exist in this planet's waters. Megalodon. Forget about the sharks of the present day for a moment. They're nothing compared to Megalodon. They look like stuffed toys compared to this behemoth. We're going to take you back in time, somewhere in the range of 23 million years ago to 3.6 million years ago. That was the time frame in which Megalodon terrorized the waters of our planet. Scientists aren't entirely certain which shark Megalodon looked most like, but they have it narrowed down to looking like either a stockier version of the basking shark, the sand tiger shark, or the great white shark. Many liken Megalodon to looking closest to the great white. Now, you may think, a stockier great white shark, what's the big deal? Stockier, but not the same size. No, not at all. A great white is usually 15 feet long, large specimens sometimes hitting 20 feet. Well, Megalodon is more than three times that size. Estimated to be about 67 feet long, Megalodon is by far the largest shark to have ever existed. It's believed Megalodon weighed 50 to 60 tons, or 100,000 to 120,000 pounds. Having trouble wrapping your mind around just what this shark looked like? Picture a great white, stockier, now stretch it out to be 3 to 3.5 times its length and its weight, equal to 9 full-grown elephants, or since we're talking orcas, 15 full-grown orcas. That is one humongous shark. There's a reason they call him Megalodon. Megalodon was believed to have lived in the oceans all over the world. Coastal, tropical, Arctic, Antarctic, wherever. So fish and other sea creatures were extremely unlucky in this time period. You couldn't turn anywhere without running into Megalodon. Here's an illustration as to how large and deadly Megalodon was. The adults mainly ate seals, sea turtles, and whales. And this shark didn't just kill, it was ruthless. The way in which it hunted was like a contract killer with something to prove. To compare, a great white when hunting often goes for the soft underside of its prey. But because Megalodon had strong jaws, even stronger than a great white, it is believed the way in which he hunted involved him using those jaws to break through his victim's chest cavity and puncturing the heart and lungs. Absolutely savage. We mentioned those jaws were stronger than the great white's bite force of 4,000 psi. That's impressive, but don't forget, we already knew that the orca had a stronger bite, devastatingly so. The orca's bite force is 19,000 psi, nearly five times the strength of the ferocious great white. But what was the Megalodon's bite like? Scientists have estimates what they believe to be a minimum and a maximum. They believe it to be between 24,000 psi and 41,000 psi, meaning at minimum, it was 5,000 psi stronger than the orcas, and at maximum, it was more than twice as strong. That essentially means you can think of something that exists, anything, and Megalodon wouldn't have just bitten through it, he would have completely shredded it to bits. It doesn't make sense that there was a pair of jaws that ever existed that was that powerful. But they did exist, and they were attached to the greatest killing machine the ocean ever saw. A mouth filled with 7-inch long teeth and a hunger for whales. I bet the orca wishes he wasn't a whale right now. Or would we be surprised? Would the orca pod put up more of a fight than we'd think? Ancient shark, meet orca pod. Let's say Megalodon didn't go extinct 3.6 million years ago. Let's say he was still swimming our waters. One, you'd be crazy to dip a toe in the ocean. Two, if you were an orca, you'd be concerned. Currently, there isn't any animal the orca cannot handle, let alone his whole pod. But now Megalodon is swimming these waters. So, what would happen? Orcas are no stranger to taking down large sharks, but even some of the largest, most dangerous sharks, like the great white, they're bigger than them. But they'll take down a sperm whale if need be, and a sperm whale is the same size as Megalodon. But here's the thing, Megalodon possesses the size of a sperm whale and the ferocity of a great white. Orcas make attack and kill these large sharks and whales, but Megalodon hunted whales, whales even bigger than the orca. Could an orca deal with the combination that Megalodon possessed? Not alone, that's a given. But orcas often work together, and a pod of orcas could be 16 strong. Megalodon was about 15 times the weight of an orca, so in terms of overall weight, it seems we have a fair fight. Orcas have a devastating bite, but the bite of Megalodon is even more devastating, and his sheer size and that wide jaw would open up and clamp down on an orca, spelling out certain doom immediately. But our orca pod is highly intelligent, able to hunt and attack in a variety of ways, and they'd soon figure out that they'd need to take Megalodon down in a specific way. With other sharks, they'd herd them to the surface and hit them with their tails, but that might not work so well with this shark that is so much larger. They may need to employ their tactic with rays, cornering them, maybe even trying to pin him down as a collective. Megalodon would not be deterred. He would fight back. He would bite back. But the orcas would need to use their speed and agility, hoping to avoid his bites and delivering bites of their own wherever they could, on his back, on his sides, on his fins. Megalodon would be taking out orca after orca with its massive bites, but as he is doing so, the other members of the orca pod would be biting away, doing as much damage as they could. As Megalodon took damage, he'd slow down. The bites from the dozens of orcas would be affecting him, and though he'd kill many of them, he might not kill them all. With an orca pod of 16, it's very possible that they'd be able to take down Megalodon. The faster they acted, the quicker they came up with a plan, the less of the pod would be lost. Orcas are so intelligent, it's quite likely they'd devise a plan immediately and act on taking down Megalodon. Then again, they've never seen Megalodon before. Would they try to take him down like any other shark? Would they see his size and think he is a slower, less agile whale? If the orca pod employed the wrong strategy to begin with, they may not have the time to strategize again. The wrong plan would see them lose several members of their pod in minutes. They might not have time to regroup, and Megalodon would rip through the entire family, crushing chests, puncturing 16 hearts, and 32 lungs. This fight could go either way. The biggest factor to pay attention to would be the intelligence of the orcas. They've never seen Megalodon before, so they'd have to assess what he was all about and come up with the right plan immediately. Depending on if they chose the right strategy or not, then you'd probably have a good idea of who would come out of this one victorious.